Hey, good morning, good afternoon, whatever time you're watching this. This is day 19. In the gym once. I'm actually still on the road. For those of you that watched yesterday, on the short video, my oldest son's surgery went fine. Now the road to recovery for him starts so that he can pitch again. I'm always feeling weird when I'm doing this in some weird place that somebody's gonna walk in. It's always about continuing to move. There's a couple things I wanted to talk about, but I'm just not feeling it right now because there's some posts I've seen on Facebook and some other places where I really think most people are dealing with symptoms, not the core issue, because really the core issue of everything that I'm talking about here for freedom is about morality, because that's where it all starts. And the vast majority of those people that I've seen on there, I'm there looking at the Constitution, they're looking at government, they're looking at whatever, but it still is going to always boil down to morality. And us coming to a common agreement on what morality is. So, well, maybe I'm kind of going into it. So let's just go ahead and do it. We're never going to get to a point where we move towards freedom. And look, we have a head start here, at least in the United States, because I can at least do this video and not worry about getting arrested. So as bad as we have it here, it could be a lot worse. And it's probably headed that direction, but wow, out of breath. It's what happens when you're on the road too, and you don't get your workouts in as cleanly as normal. But yeah, it's really about morality. Every issue that we're dealing with is about morality. And for people to understand what morality is, and starting with the concept and the idea that to do no harm, to harm no one, or to instigate harm on no one. And it's really that simple. And as I get a little better at this, I'll try to talk about how harm is getting instigated on us in many ways that we don't even think about it. Right now people are having a hard time affording food. Some people aren't, a lot of people aren't, but most people, a good chunk of people are worried about jobs, all that stuff. And I think we really are gonna have to take a step back and decide what is actually important to us. Is it important to us to accumulate shit? When people die, are they gonna sit here and go, "Man, I am so glad I had that BMW, I mean, wow, all the way up to that Lamborghini for some of those people." Is it gonna matter? No. But what is gonna matter is the legacy that you and I leave behind. There's a generation that came before mine. I'm in Generation X, I guess. I don't care about the generation stuff because people are just individuals. And I think making these large group assumptions is freaking stupid. But we are at a crossroads now where we can decide which way we want to go. And which we've always actually been at those crossroads. But I know I'm starting to ramble. Let me gather my thoughts here again. But let's circle back to morality. And would it be moral for me to make stuff that you own worth less? Would it be moral for me to agree to pay you $100,000 in your salary, and then at the end of the year only pay you $95,000? It sounds dumb, right? But the equivalent has happened because a group of people that have access to money and can create money at will do it, push it into the economy, making the agreed upon $100,000 that you were going to work for worth $95,000 by the end of the year. So, yeah, we're going to start going. Well, I've been going that direction the whole time. I know I'm rambling. I'm tired, dude. A lot of freaking traveling the last couple of days, and hopefully today we surprise someone that didn't know we're going to be where we are. So, I'm coming from Dodge City, Kansas today, where my youngest is playing some baseball, and he didn't know his big brother was going to show up after having elbow surgery. So anyway, that's totally random in what we're talking about here. But again, if we are truly interested in being free, the legacy that we leave, is it going to be accumulating shit and imprisoning ourselves more? Or is it going to be living a more free life that isn't encumbered by people, a small group of people that think that they're entitled to our shit, to our efforts, to, I want to figure out how to break down just something that was created by the company I work for around estate planning. I really do hate to hit estate planning because it impacts so few people, but it is mind-boggling that some of the smartest people on the planet, as far as computer programming can compile this magical software and never question the laws that cause them to have to give them the opportunity to create the software in the first place. How shit is literally stolen from people because they didn't go through a legal system to structure things in a way that the government didn't take it from them. I personally believe that the estate tax was probably created to steal land because people, I live in Kansas, out here in Western Kansas, people own a ton of land and they're not dollar rich. So if they own a bunch of land and they don't have this structured right, at the end of their lives, their family may wind up having to sell their land to pay the freaking estate tax. But anyway, that's a whole different story. Morality is where we got to start, and we got to be and not tolerate harming others in any way, shape, or form. And when we start moving that direction, we're going to do something. For those that made it to this part, I know I've rambled the whole time. This is day 19. Get out, sweat, get in shape, and let's start working towards freedom. Bye.